Suppose it's possible.
It's, on average, the higher a person, or the less controlled a person's type 2 diabetes is, so the higher their hemoglobin A1c would go, the more likely they are to have what we call atherogenic dyslipidemia, which involves a low HDL and a high triglyceride. So on average, high triglycerides and high hemoglobin A1c values go together. Mm-hmm. But people vary quite a bit one from another, and it's very possible that somebody could have a triglyceride under 150, which is the upper limit of considered normal. We like them under 100.
Yeah.
And still have a high hemoglobin A1c. The other factor is triglycerides can go down very quickly when you cut out dietary carbs. But your hemoglobin A1c value takes 3 to 4 months to change. When you, so one might see triglycerides plummet in the first, say, month of a well-formulated ketogenic diet. And the hemoglobin A1c is going to tag along quite a bit behind. So typically we wait anywhere from 4 to 6 months after people make it, the change to a low-carbohydrate diet before we do that testing so that the hemoglobin A1c can, which is a slow responder, catches up to some of the factors which respond more promptly.